Okay, I think we're going to go ahead and get started. Looks like we've got most people in. There'll be a few more shuffling in. And we are really pleased to have Mark Leibovit in the room. Mark is one of my favorite partners that we work with. He's a fantastic market timer. He's one of the best that there's ever been. And we're just pleased to have him as a partner with MetaStock. We've got his VR trading system. As a part of MetaStock as an add-in, it's one of our very best, and we're excited to have him in here to show you the ins and outs of it and describe how he uses it. Let me go ahead, before we start, we need to go ahead and just read down our standard disclaimer. For legal purposes, we always do this, anyone who's been in our webinars. So if you just bear with me for a moment while I read this to you. This demonstration is designed to instruct you on using MetaStock and accompanying software plugins, and is not a recommendation to buy or sell, but rather guidelines to interpreting and using specific indicators and features within the software. The information, software, and techniques presented today should only be used by investors who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. MetaStock shall have no liability for any investment decisions based on the use of their software, any trading strategies, or any information provided in connection with the company. All right, thank you. You'll notice that there is a chat bar on the left today, and you're welcome to put in some questions there as we go through. I'm going to let Mark kind of moderate this. I don't know if he wants to take any of those questions during the presentation or have you wait, but that will be your opportunity to get very specific with him. If you do have any audio problems today, it's typically from your internet connection. Don't panic, just log out, log right back in, and typically that'll solve it. All right. Well, I'm very excited to introduce you to and turn the time over to Mark Leibovit. Mark, go ahead and take it away.
Thanks, Dave. Hello, everybody. It's Mark Leibovit, and happy to join you guys for our webinar this afternoon. It's obviously an exciting time in the market. But with my VR analysis, it's always an exciting time because we're just looking for trading opportunities in any market climate, and bull or bear. So as long as we have some volatility and we generate volume in either direction, that's pretty much what we're looking for. And I should say that my focus is shorter term. We create an indicator that has intermediate importance, particularly if we start putting it on the weekly or monthly charts. But my primary focus, coming from a day trading background on the floor of the CBOE many years ago, is a shorter term viewpoint, meaning that I look at this as a way of making a living, not as a way to get rich. And I think I've told Dave and others at MetaStock this story, but basically when I was on the floor years ago, the traders that I admired the most were the ones that went flat every day, took their cash off the table, and started fresh every day in the marketplace. And that inspired me over the years. That way, you have a clean slate coming in every day. You don't have to worry about positions going the opposite direction at the opening. And you can always find new stuff, as you're going to see in some of these examples, where a volume reversal is posted negative or positive, and you jump in the next morning and you can catch a trade even for multiple days, but certainly on a day or two basis. So that's, sort of the philosophy behind it. I think I'm going to there's my picture for you guys, and this is my website, VR Trader. My Trader's Book of Volume, by the way, is a little bit of a commercial plug here, is available on Amazon, and we do devote a little space in the book to the volume reversal, though most of it's an encyclopedia of most volume indicators, something which really didn't exist before we created the book. And for those of you who speak Chinese, there's a Chinese version of it too, which may offer some opportunities out in the Far East for me if I can ever learn the language, which I don't think is going to happen so quickly at this stage of my life. But I don't know if you know much about my background besides the floor trading. I've done a lot of media stuff over the years. I guess the biggest claim to fame for me was working with Lewis Rukeyser for a number of years as an elf on the Wall Street Week television program, which is a real thrill. And I also got noted by Timer Digest over a number of years for calling the market. But like anything, you can't be a top quarterback every year, and you do your best to stay on top of the pack. The indicator is proprietary. I kept it pretty much secret for about 30-35 years, and we came out and we released it a couple years ago with MetaStock. And the basic concept for you. Well, maybe just summarize here for you where we have different versions of it. We have the sequential, directional, and two-day, and we'll go over those with you during the course of the presentation. And we have versions that cover these various markets as well, as you'll see on the add-on. I guess the real question is, first, what is a volume reversal? The visual on the screen is a two-day. So, you know, volume reversal is basically a change of price and a change of volume and in the direction of the price. And it's displayed on the charts as a positive or negative VR. This the concept that volume precedes price is really what it's based on. And though the formula is proprietary, this is not rocket science. When I was on the floor trading, we pretty much just watched the volume flows. And generally, if a big buyer or seller comes in, there's momentum in that direction, which carries possibly not only for that day, but for several days following the pattern. So we've noticed that there's about a 70% probability that when you get a volume reversal, you get a day or two follow through. And that's why we created this first version that's defined on the screen here is the Leibovit volume reversal 2-day. And we know there's a quick example here. I put up Fannie Mae. It's one of the little stocks that I trade. It's a $3 stock, and I love cheap stocks just for the leverage. But what you're looking at here is how it's signaled on the add-on platform, where let's just circle in here in the middle of the screen, which was in November, where I get a negative VR. That just tells me sellers are coming in right off the top. We're overbought here on the stochastic, so it's telling you that you're probably at a top anyway. And the two-day says 2 days later, you get out and take a profit. And that's what this little blue dot is you see here. So as soon as you're getting the VR, and I do encourage you, by the way, to have live data so you can catch these intraday. When I see these going on during the day, I jump in as they're forming. But according to the two-day rule, you get short here, and you're out 2 days later. And regardless of where it went later, just capitalizing on the theory that you get some follow through in a couple days. Here in December, we had a positive VR. I don't have the exact date here because this is a picture of the chart, not the live platform, which we do have available here for questions later. But a positive VR comes in 2 days later, we're out with a trading profit, regardless of the fact that it continued going. Another positive VR comes in here a couple days later. We jump in 2 days later, we're out at a profit. Of course, you could have gotten out before that, but the rule is, you know, within 2 days, take your profit, and so on and so forth. You can see there's a pretty strong correlation here that when you get the VRs, there tends to be followed through both on the upside and the downside. Moving on here, let me briefly define the next version of the VR, and believe me, we got plenty of examples here. I just want to get the definitions behind us. The directional indicator, you know, filters out repetitive volume reversals. And I probably should have shown you the sequential first. Let me just skip ahead here because this is the one that I tend to use more. The sequential shows all volume reversals, all positive, negative. I personally like to see all of them. The directional, which I just skipped over, filters out repetitive volume reversals. But let's look at the sequential first because this is sort of my favorite. Again, I threw up Fannie Mae and just because it's a decent example. But every VR is being posted on the screen. The negative, each positive, you see everyone, and when there's consecutive ones, it counts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, reconfirming the uptrend. So the sequential shows all of them, and that's all you need to know about the sequential. Now we go back to the directional. This is the same chart, but it filtered out repetitive volume reversals, and I blew it up a little bit. So if there's a two negative VRs together, it'll only show the most recent one. If you remember, there was a series of positive VRs here on the other chart. It just showed the VR before there was a negative VR, or unless you were stopped out of the trade. So basically, the pattern filters out for you. Now this might be useful to many of you. I don't want this counted. A lot of my clients do use it, but as I said a moment ago, I like to see all the VRs and just tie in with my other indicators. So let's move on a little bit here. We're just going to show you some examples, and obviously we have plenty of time here. I don't want to bore you with a lot of, you know, examples. Many of these are current. On the other hand, you may have some questions on some specific other examples, but I try to make this as current as possible. This is one of my recent trading favorites, GW Pharmaceutical. This is a medical marijuana play, and as you probably have been noting, some of the particularly cheap marijuana stocks have been hot recently. This is one of my favorite trading areas in the last few months, but basically, we had some nice correlation here with the positive VR coming in. And again, I'm going to back up a second. What is a positive VR? It's basically buyers coming in on a rally day on more volume. And when you see two little green lines together, that means volume increased the second day after the first day, which reinforces the uptrend. So what I tend to do is I look at the VR. I see where we are on our stochastic indicator. You can use other indicators, other momentum indicators. I like the stochastic. And if the stochastic is more or less in an uptrend, I tend to go with the VR. If you get a positive VR like up here and you can see the stochastic in a downtrend, I tend not to use it because that sort of tells me we're overbought. And the theory about the VRs is you like to catch the positive ones off bottoms like here. And you like to catch negative ones off little trading tops like here. You don't like to catch a positive VR after a stock's already rallied a bit coming off of a top. So I think that's what the stochastic is telling you, that you don't take this trade. This one you would, because you're coming off of a oversold reading, you're tending to move higher, and then you get a sign of a buyer stepping to the plate here, and that gets you into the trade. As you can see, it was profitable, and you had a reinforcing positive VR and just carried you up and up and up. So we're just going to go through some more examples like this. And another thing I'm pointing out to you is you can look at the screen. I don't have a bunch of indicators up here. My approach is very simplistic. And this is how I trade, and this is how I make a living doing this. My problem is there's hundreds of situations that I miss because I can't see every stock. And there's a group that I tend to follow. I have a watch list that I follow, and I sort of play off that watch list. But I must miss, you know, hundreds of trades a day because obviously I can't be in all those trades anyway, or I don't see them. I mean, just so much action in the marketplace. So you got to focus on ones that make sense to you or you feel will generate some follow-through for you. This is Apple Computer before the break. All these negative VRs were coming in here telling you there was something wrong. One little positive came in, which they did give you a little bit of a trade, but more negatives came in, and sure enough, we had this big break in the last 10 days or so. In all fairness, I did not get a positive VR off the 495 bottom that occurred about 7-8 days back. I did not get positive VR, so I did not make this trade. Doesn't mean I'm going to catch every move. Back here, you saw a nice positive VR before a big move. Here, you got a nice positive VR before a nice rally, negative VR before a downtrend. So you're not going to get a VR in every situation that you want. Up here, for example, there was no negative volume coming off that peak, so I did not play that. So what I'm fishing for is when I do get the signals, and that's why you have to be looking at more than one stock. Here are the spiders. This is one of the reasons I got bearish on the market in the beginning of the year, besides the fact that the January barometer, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with, turned negative with the first 5 days of January being down. But once you start getting a series of negative VRs like this, this tells you the market's going to go into a correction, which is indeed exactly what we've seen. And in all fairness, the current rally, I did not generate a positive VR, which is frustrating for me, obviously, because I like to have reversed the market and been long here on this current move, though I was playing some individual stocks, as you can see. The S&P did not give me a positive VR off the low, and this was nearly a thousand point in the Dow, 100-point correction in the S&P we're looking at. So on this particular rally, again, I played some individual stocks, but the index itself did not give me the trade, whereas you can see in other instances, I did get the trade. Does that mean perhaps this is a dead cat bounce? This is not really a move to new highs? Don't know yet. Perhaps maybe we pull back, and then I generate a VR a few days from now, or a week from now, and then I get long the market for another leg up. But on this particular formation, the S&P did not give me the signal. As you can see, we are starting to get overbought here on the stochastic anyway. Solar City, of course, is a big play. It's one of my favorite trading stocks. It's extremely volatile. When you get a signal, you can see you get some nice follow-through. The positive VR is nice follow-through here. Negative VR, you only had a day or two trade here. But if you caught it intraday, there was a nice move there. And basically, on the positive VRs, you're getting some quick follow-through. Even on the last 3 or 4 days here, you get negative VR, and the stock pulls back right after the sellers start to come in. So it's like the Netflix and the big group stocks here. You want something that can generate some points for you, particularly like situations like this where you get a positive VR and it gaps up the next day and you've got a nice profit right away. So that's why Solar City is I find a good trading vehicle, one of the group that I tend to look at. Needless to say, Google could be on the list too because it has some follow-through after signals here. Basically, some are only 1 or 2 day plays like we saw back here. Here's only a 1 or 2 day play here. Here's a 2 or 3 day play here. Here's a several day play here. Again, if you only take 1 or 2 days, that's fine with me because I'm just looking to trade anyway. Negative VR here about 10 days ago. You get a nice couple day break. And here, same thing to the upside. Positive VR comes in. See here, we're looking at the market vectors, gold miners. Of course, I've been a little bullish on the gold stocks here for the last couple of months, but in recent weeks, you can see why. We've got all these series of positive VRs coming in here on the sequential, counting all the VRs. And today, this is today's chart. This is the market vectors for the big cap gold stocks broke out above the 200-day moving average. So I don't know how far this is all going to go, but we are in an uptrend here, and the street is skeptical about gold and gold stocks. I wouldn't be that inclined to chase it here. Basically, you got a couple gaps, and you've been running here 2 or 3 days, and you're starting to get a little overbought. But until volume turns negative here, I think there's a little bit more coming, and I'd probably be fishing for a little bit of pullback. If you're a subscriber to VR Trader, you're long from back here on this positive VR and then this positive VR. So we already have several points profit in GDX based on these previous signals. If volume starts to slow here to the upside, I may just take the trade. And you have to check with the newsletter for details there, of course. Here's Zynga. A lot of my clients seem to like the stock. I don't really care for it that much, but it does seem to have a little correlation on the VRs. So you're just looking at a picture of Zynga here and how the positive VRs seem to translate into at least day or two follow through, negative VR day or two follow through. So you understand what I'm looking for here. If I jump in, you know, I'm out in a day or two and I'm tickled pink that I got the trade. Here's Whole Foods Market. I love situations like this, by the way. And this, I don't know how many examples we really could bring to your attention today. But if you recall, back in November, they came out with a negative news story. I think the Whole Foods disappointed earnings, and they gapped the stock down. And it's been pretty much trending down sideways. I think they did this to so many stocks, but in the last year or so with Nike. So when I see this formation and the gap down, I know what's going to happen. They're going to eventually come back and fill this gap. So at some point, you got to start looking for the buy signals. And we got one here for a little bit of a trade, but we're long for VR Trader based on this one here that came in about 10 days ago. Very encouraged that both the 50-day and 200-day moving averages have been taken out. And I don't know if this is the move that's going to come back and fill that gap, but when I see big gap situations like this, I tend to wait for the bottoming pattern and the volume to come in to tell me that, hey, this is the time both to jump in for a trade and possibly the advent of a bigger move that ultimately will come back and fill the gap. This is a marijuana stock, believe it or not, Creative Edge. It's a little penny play. Now, you might think that I don't play stuff like this, but I do, and I have a lot of fun doing it. I think this stock was trading like 10, 15 million shares a day, and we just traded it the last couple of days and had a nice little percentage move, you know, like from, you know, 5 cents up to 8 cents, and I think it pulled back here a little bit today, but it was starting to show some accumulation back here. So I'm watching all the marijuana stocks because I think there's going to be a lot more coming, and I think they're a little overbought here, need to pull back, but I don't care where I make the money. I can make it in a 4 cent stock to 20 cents. I don't know if I have an example here of HEMP or not. I know that's the hemp that ran from 7 cents to 34 cents here in the last 3 or 4 days. So big volume there. We'll see if we get to that visual. I don't know if we posted it here. Here, quickly, we're looking at, by the way, answer your questions here. I see some questions coming in. Yes, these are all daily charts. I don't think I put up examples of 60-minute or weekly. We can do that, you know, when we have time for questions here. But I tend to focus on the dailies. What we're looking at here is the Rio Tinto, which, of course, is a metals and mining play down in Australia. And this is an example of the 2-day indicator at work for Rio Tinto. So positive VR, you're out 2 days later. The rule is on the VRs with the 2-day, if you get a positive and you get a negative, that immediately reverses the trade. So you were long here, but you immediately reversed here, and you'll see that in the manual or in the on the screen when you touch the bar, it gives you the instructions. But negative VR, quick follow through here for 2 days, positive VR. No signals in here. We weren't playing it. And this is another example of correlation with the VRs in a hot sector, which is what we have going right now in the metals, at least short term. Rand Gold, another one of my favorites. Look how this beautifully defined the downtrend here with all the negative VRs all the way down, except for one little bad signal here, so to speak, in the middle of the downtrend. It pretty much confirmed it. And then we got a positive signal here and a series of positives here. So, nice correlation with Randgold. It's ticker symbol G-O-L-D. Some tell me this is one of the higher quality gold stocks compared to the Newmonts and the Barricks. I think we already looked at Google. W.W. Granger, this is a trade we had today for VR Trader clients. We had a positive VR, and we bought at the opening. I think it was actually bought this yesterday at the opening, and the stock had a nice move today. It was up 4 or 5 points in the session, and after it was building a little base here, the stochastic was in an uptrend. This was my signal. I just jumped in. I know this is a very expensive stock, and this may not be one you're comfortable with, but we bought it, I think, around 231, went to 237, 238, and it looks high to me. With the volume coming in here, I think it should trade a bit higher. I thought maybe trade into the 240s, but we do have the trade, and even if we jumped out here, we'll have to look at it in the morning and decide if we're going to exit it here. But look here, as it came down on the negative VR, you had a nice follow through here, and this is, I assume, was a news story at the time. Positive VR here, carried it up for a couple days. So you can't be afraid of price. The Googles of the world and the price lines and the Grangers, you know, you just have to adjust your positions or play options. Rio Tinto already showed that one. Smith & Wesson, this has been one of my big favorites. I think we showed this in a previous webinar. Of course, I've been in the gun stocks for a couple, 3 years here. Sturm Ruger, RGR, and Smith & Wesson. We're long here for VR Trader. We've just watched it decline here in the last few weeks, and I was waiting for some positive volume to come in, so we bought it here day before yesterday for the service. It's only a $12 stock. Of course, you know, one might argue there's resistance at the blue line, which is your 50-day moving average. We'll see if it goes through there or not, but we also have this nice little gap up here at 14. So this might surprise the bears a little bit. This might continue moving forward, but we're long, and we're in Smith & Wesson at this time on that little signal. Here's the hemp. This is what I was joking a little bit to you about before earlier. Had a big run, and it's come down quite a bit, but we jumped in here. It was around 9, 10 cents, ran all the way up to 34 cents, and volume came in. We got out of the trade, and now we're looking to get back in again, but I would like to see some positive volume to get back in. But this is in the speculative, emphasizing the word speculative, marijuana group, and there's about two dozen stocks, if you look up on the internet, that are trading, you know, anywhere from 5 cents to $1.50 that are in this group. So I'm in them. Why? Because huge volume came in. I think this traded a couple 300 million shares. So it's just attracting my interest because it's flashing as volume comes in, and just an interesting, fun trade. I guess it's an option that may or may not expire, but it's certainly something to look at. I think we've covered the main visuals. I didn't want to sit here lecturing you guys on and on, so I wanted to at least give you a sense of the general parameters, and I'd like to take a few moments here for you to ask some questions and look at some specific examples. I'm looking at some of these questions here before we get to those examples, and I'll wait for some of the input from you guys. The explanation of a VR, volume reversal, essentially is a move from a rally to a reaction. In other words, an up day to a down day on more volume, or a down day to an up day on more volume. And there's some subtleties to the calculation, but that's essentially what we're looking at. You know, we tend to ignore inside days and outside days in the market, and we like to see a pure play from a trading bottom or a trading top. You know, the indicator is a very powerful and simplistic indicator, and it just tells you there are more buyers than sellers, or more sellers than buyers. And if you're trading, you want that momentum, and that's what the volume reversal does for you. And this is how, really, pretty much how I make my living, just following these shifts in volume. Let's see here. My exit signal is a question here. My exit signal. So let's back up a second. Let's just look to see what I would normally do. Look at hemp, because this is just a little speculative play. If I get a positive VR here, I tend to use the bar just before the bar before the lowest bar just before the VR is my mental stop. In other words, if this is your low and accumulation is coming in right off that bottom, this is where you want to keep your stop. And that's essentially what we do, you know, give or take a little fudge factor that you may want to put there. That's generally what you do. And if you're getting a negative VR off a top, your stop is right where the selling came off of, or that peak there. So obviously you're not shorting it down here, but if you're catching it during the day as it's coming down, you want to keep a stop from the bar just previous to where the selling began, because it really shouldn't go back there. If big sellers have stepped in here, they're getting out of it and shouldn't go back to that high. Same thing here. If the buyers are coming in, it's not going back to that low. And if it does, there's something wrong with the trade, and you want to get out of it. You can look at like an example here. Here's a positive VR in Smith & Wesson. You're getting a positive VR here. It looks like early in January. This is your low point just before the volume comes in. So the buyer stepped in, they came right off this low, and this is where you want to keep a mental stop. You don't want to see go back through that level, because that's where the reversal pattern occurred. So that's what I generally do. So here's the trade that we just have for VR Trader, which I mentioned a few moments ago. Our stop is right over here. We're long the stock, it's moved in our direction. We may choose to just trade out of it tomorrow, but I wouldn't want to go beyond this point, because that's the reversal point. Let's see here, other questions. The question here is, end of day probably not good for this system. I have mixed feelings about answering that question. I tend to use intraday, because I like to see the volume coming in during the day so I can jump in rather than wait to the end of the day. But in many instances, you can get a positive VR. Let's say here, you can jump in the next day at the opening and still make money. So sometimes, it just is valid. I tend to want to get that little edge, and if I see it developing during the day, I tend to want to jump in while it's forming. But I can show you dozens of beautifully positive examples, even if you looked at it at the end of the day. And for me, because I'm scanning so many stocks, I don't see everything. I tend to see a lot of stuff end of day because I didn't catch it during the day. And I say, oh, there's a VR. In fact, the Granger trade, and if you back up here to see it, the GWW, I didn't see this during the day. I actually saw it after the close, and I said, oh, there's a VR in this thing. Look at this chart. The stock's way down. The stochastic's up. This could probably bounce a little bit. So I actually jumped in after the VR the next day and still made money with this thing. So I mixed response to your answer. If you could get a live feed, I think that would be a good idea, but it's not mandatory. It says, I read your book on volume and considered to be one of the best technical book of the 200 I've read. Well, thank you very much. I wish we sold about 10,000 more copies of it, but thank you very much. You put a lot of work into the book, and there were a couple indicators that I didn't get in there. McGraw-Hill was a very difficult publisher to work with, but thank you for that. And there's a little insight in the VR in there, but it's not extensive. You get more looking at the MetaStock screen than you will get from the book, but it does give you some nice examples. Is there a way of getting the signal before the close? The only way you would do that is if you're doing it manually, following the volume, eyeballing it from the day before on your screen, and you see it rallying, and you just compare the volume. You might be able to ascertain it without having live data. Sometimes I do that myself. I just eyeball the screen, and I get a good sense what you're using. Now, what are you using in the stochastic system? Well, thank you, Michael, for your comment there. I have a 533 stochastic, which is very sensitive. Some people don't like using it that tight. It's a 533, so it's very sensitive to the changes. And again, it's not perfect, but it gives you a little bit of a guide, and it's something that I like to look at. But as you can see, I don't look at very much. All you're looking at the screen is the VRs. I put a 200-day and 50-day moving average up just to see what everybody else is looking at. And I'm a little cynical about the 50-day, because I think it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. You know what I mean? When the 200-day is broken, everybody starts to sell under it or buy above it. I've seen many instances in my work where I'll get a positive VR here. It'll rally to the 50-day, or just take it out and get everybody excited. And by then, I'm long gone and out of the trade. But it's a good reference point just to see what everybody's looking at. And you want to get a good feel for what's going on out there. So outside of that, I'm really not looking at very much on the screens. And I really don't need it, because these VRs are gifts. And it's just a question of, you know, how much time do I have to find the one that I'm going to trade? And I just have a select universe of stocks that I find. And if I'm lucky enough to find something overnight, like I did here, then, you know, I certainly try to take advantage of it. But I only have one set of eyeballs, and you can only trade so many vehicles. I want to know about Nugget. Dave, if you're on board, can we switch to the live MetaStock? We can look at some live examples.
Sure, let's do that. I'll go ahead and set that up for you.
I think someone's asking about Nugget, so I might as well put it up and see if we got anything. Thank you.
Okay, here's the module. Just go ahead and click the drop-down menu and to share your screen there. Okay, looks good. Looks like we have it now.
You have it there, okay. So let's see. I generally don't trade the double or triple ETFs. I usually go for the singles, but doesn't mean it. So you can't make money with them. So let's see what Nugget looks like. We've asked about this one. So I'm going to put the sequential indicator up because this is the one I told you I sort of follow. It shows you all the VRs. So I'm putting the 50-day sequential, meaning it's got the 50-day moving average. This is just. Ones that I preset on my screen. These are like preset versions of it. The ones that you get on your drop-down menu from the expert advisor wouldn't have this designation, but I created these, so just a little shortcut for me. I'm sure many of you know how to do this. So let's blow it up. So you can see a strong correlation here with Nugget. And it's been actually unbelievable when you think about what's been happening in the stock here or in the ETF here since December 4th. You got your first signal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. MetaStock only counts up to number 6. And this is just something to do with the programming of MetaStock. This is actually number 7, but for some reason it doesn't count beyond 6. But you have to ask the programmers about that question. But in any event, you can see here, this clearly is defined the uptrend. You're above the blue 50-day moving average. So your resistance is up here, I would guess, around the 200-day, and you're on the move here. So sure looks like an uptrend to me. I don't see any negative volume yet. I see a couple little gaps here. You're starting to get a little overbought. I'm already in GDX, so I don't know if I want to jump into this one here, even though the trend's up, but if I could get a little pullback in it, I probably would feel pretty good about it. Somebody wants to look at SODA. Let's put up SODA. SodaStream. I think it's a good use of time, Dave, that we're getting some questions in here. I feel like, you know, if you're doing a presentation and you only show the examples you want to look at, people feel like you prejudice the presentation. So here, if it doesn't work, you'll know right away, right? This is the way to go about it. All right, so here's SodaStream on a daily chart. And all I can say is you got, mixed signals. The most recent one was positive here 4 or 5 days ago, so you got a little buy signal and you moved up here. Here you were, you got a positive signal, but I don't know if I'd have taken this trade or not. In hindsight, it would have been a losing trade if I did, but you're a little overbought on the stochastic here, and I don't know if I'd have taken the trade. But if you did take the trade, you might have stopped out in a day or two because you didn't really get the follow-through, but there's certainly a gap here. I like to have seen a negative VR here to give us the short trade, but it didn't happen. Here you did get a nice little negative VR, and that caught this little down move. This little positive VR was really didn't create any follow-through. Negative VR here. This is a good exercise. What I tend to do is that if I'm looking at a new situation like a soda or like a nugget, I'll pull up a chart and see how strong the correlation is on the VRs to that particular stock or index. The theory is the same and should apply across the board, but you are going to find some situations where it just works a lot better than others, and I can't explain why that would happen, but for the most part, you get the correlation you're looking for. So I'm pretty happy with this. Negative VR really didn't go anywhere. It went a little bit lower. You got a positive VR here, but you immediately got a reversal signal. So if you were long that trade, you would have reversed it and you would have caught this move. You'd have caught a day move up here. You'd have caught a minimal move here. So So it depends where you are on these stochastics. This trade I wouldn't have taken here because the stochastic was in the downtrend. This trade I probably would have taken because it was a negative VR and you're overbought. So you have to call your shots on these to see if you think this is a reliable play or not for you. But as a general statement, I think this has got a pretty good correlation here. And you have to. This worries me a little bit here about if we possibly would have been in this trade and got caught on this without the warning. But the stock was in a downtrend. You were trading under the 50-day moving average, so it certainly wasn't an up stock. And generally, you want to see something trending higher, like the nugget. And in that case, you're more likely to play the long side than something like this. Tesla GMCR is on the screen, so let's look up Tesla. I was trading Tesla for myself last couple of days, and I got out of it on a trade here just because the thing moves so fast. Let's see here. I got to remind myself what I did on that trade already. Let's pull up Tesla. Putting again the sequential 50-day. Okay, just blowing it up here a little bit for you. Okay, here's Tesla, clearly an up stock, trading above its 50-day moving average. Most recent signal was 3 days ago. You got a positive VR, and you got a day or two follow-through. So in hindsight, you could have jumped in here, around the mid-180s and went to the mid-190s. That's as of today. A few days before that, we had a little negative VR, so you caught it somewhere in the 170s to the mid-180s, and where'd it get down to here in 2 days? Got down to 169. So there were a few points here. This one, there was no real follow-through to the downside following this negative VR. So this one, you would have either stopped out or just, blown out the trade. This positive VR created some nice follow-through. This one here showed the trend was going up, but this didn't create the trade that I would have liked, so that would not have worked out. As a general rule, if I'm getting a VR, I like to see some follow-through with, in a day, and if I don't get it, I usually back out of the trade. So this one here, I probably would have been out of. And that's pretty much it. What I'm looking at here is not a real – there's mixed – correlation in Tesla. We got some nice sell signals here. It's moving down nicely. Here you got a little play to the upside. This seems to be working pretty well, but I noticed this one didn't work too well and this one didn't work well. So we got two or three here, which isn't too bad over a 4 or 5 month period, but it's not 100%, but no indicator is 100%. So that's my view of Tesla at the moment. This has been a trade here for a couple of days, and I'd probably be out of it just for that. And GMCR, Green Mountain Coffee, of course, it had that huge move with the Coca-Cola announcement. So I did look at this after Coke came out with the deal announcement, and I'm not quite sure what I saw here. Let me remind myself, I'm looking at so many stocks. Let's look at GMCR here. Obviously, I didn't trade this one because I'd be bragging to you about how well I did on it. Let's see here. Nope, there was, the stochastic was up, but there was no positive VR prior to the signal. We had a little negative VR about 10 days back. You got 2 or 3 days down in the stock, which would probably have been enough for me to take the trade. But we did not get a positive VR here for that trade. So can't take credit for Coca-Cola or any inside information there. But it seems to have, some pretty decent correlation here. And, the bottom line is, what am I saying? I'm saying buyers came in here and there was some follow-through. Sellers came in here, but buyers immediately stepped in afterwards and there was follow-through. Sellers came in here, there was a little bit of follow-through to the downside. Sellers came in here, there was a little follow-through. So basically, this is either institutional money or just big traders moving the stock. And I'm just looking for the trade based on their actions. I'm not trying to say that this is a sign of a major move in the stock, but there seems to be a pretty decent correlation here on the trade. And again, you want to see where you are in the move. Like this positive VR here, I would not have taken the trade. Why? Because stochastic's in a downtrend, okay? This positive VR here is coming off a bottom. I may or may not have taken that trade. This one I definitely wouldn't have taken the trade because the stochastic was in a downtrend. This negative VR I would not have taken this trade because we were in an uptrend in the stochastic. This positive VR I would have taken because we were in an uptrend. So you can see how my thought process is here, and you got to call your shots. Let's see, Twitter. Let's put up Twitter. Another question. I appreciate you sending in the ideas because this keeps me intellectually honest here about what's working or not. I'm personally trading Twitter because it filled a gap, and I think it's awfully cheap here, but it has to fill the gap. I should say it hasn't filled the gap. Okay. Well, you definitely don't take the negative VR the day they broke the stock. This is on the earnings disappointment. This is 4 days back. And, you know, when you come out with a bad news story, you generally don't take a trade like that for sure. Here's a negative VR here. I would not have taken that trade because, you know, we're already oversold. We're already down here a little bit. I wouldn't have taken that one either. There isn't a lot in Twitter. As you can see, there aren't many signals. The stock's been trading for a relatively short period of time. And I'm going all the way back here. We only have, you know, three or four or five signals in the last several months. So there really isn't enough history here. And I guess my initial response is, A, we don't have enough history. And B, I don't see enough in terms of, you know, examples and correlation to say, hey, this is a high confidence stock that I want to be trading with my my system. So basically, I'm just I personally bought the stock because, you know, just me. And I'll tell you one of the reasons for that was is because you had a an old high here that had to be corrected. I think it was this high here was around 50. I'm trying to remember where I got the number from. There was an old high that hadn't been corrected in the stock when they came down here to 50. Might have been back here. I think it's this level here, and I just figured it corrected enough on a bad start and it would trade up. So we're just trading it for a couple points here, and you are oversold. But certainly no volume to confirm it, and I would just pass on Twitter for now. ICPT, let's look at that one. Intercept. I know this is a high flyer. All right, hopefully we're long. We gave a signal on that big gap. Let's see what came up here. Well, this is one of those dream situations that I can't take credit for because I'm not in, but this is the kind of thing you want to see where you got a positive VR. And the next day it gaps up huge and it continues to run. So obviously there were some insiders that knew the story was coming. This is the kind of thing you would want to see in Twitter on the other side, negative, and we didn't get it. But obviously somebody knew something was coming at a positive VR. You may not have bought the stock, but if you did, you had this huge move, you would probably run for the hills and just take your profit. And there was another positive VR about 10, 12 days before that. So interesting little pattern. You got to blow this thing up because it's on such a big scale, but anyway, that's this is the kind of thing you write textbooks about. You can say, well, there's positive VR before the news story, and it's based on the idea that, you know, there's going to be smart money out there. When I say smart buyers and sellers are coming in, these are people that generally either have a sense of news or just very savvy traders. So you really don't need to be an insider to make money in the market. If you can find some of these signals, and you're not going to find them in all situations, but certainly that is what you're looking for. So I don't have any, you know, more questions here. We go over some other examples. If you guys have some other ones you want to take a look at, I'm just, again, emphasizing that, you know, this is something you guys really, if you're not already using the VR, I use it as standalone. You know, I don't look at other indicators. I don't have any. I know there's hundreds of out there you can put up on the screen, but this is how I trade, and it's a very simple way for me to, you know, address the markets. I'm either following a buy or following a sell, and obviously it's a subjective call. Do you jump in on that trade or not? But you know, you just, I'm sure most of you have been trading for a period of time. You get a feel for the market, and you get a good sense this is for real. But when you get a stock like the you know, Smith & Wesson I showed you, something coming off a bottom with a VR, you certainly want to take a look at it. Is there any significance to the numbers after the signal? Is a 6 a better signal than a 2? If you're talking about the counting of them, yes. That means it reconfirms the trend that the ETF or the stock is in. But I tend to be out of the trades before that. In other words, if I get a VR, I could be out the next day or the day after, and there could be several more VRs in the days ahead reconfirming the trend, but I may not be in the trade that long. I guess one of the things you can look at is, you know, weekly charts and see if you're getting the patterns on the weekly. I don't have a weekly example here to show you, but you can convert some of these charts to weekly. Let's just do it here for the heck of it on this intercept and just see what it looks like. This is one of the fun things that MetaStock allowed me to do. See, when I'm doing this for myself for years, I have my own software, but I'm pretty much looking at daily charts, and I'm not looking at weekly charts because I didn't have the programming. And here, it gives you the ability to see what the pattern would be on a weekly basis. So we're looking at intercept now on a weekly chart, and it's really interesting because you're getting a VR here. Way back here, when was this? On December 6th. So on a weekly chart, you theoretically could have been long the stock weeks ahead of time. You had a negative VR in the stock here in October when it was trading around, it looks around, it's about $60. And it traded down to about 52 afterwards. So theoretically, you'd have been on a weekly chart, you'd have been short the stock until a positive came in, and you'd have been up a few points in it, and then reversed your position. Here on a weekly chart, you'd have been long the stock back here in October, somewhere in the mid-40s, and you'd have been out of it somewhere in the 60s or 70s before this negative VR comes in. So this is part of the testing process. If you pull up your stock on the weekly and you see a good correlation, and if you're more of an intermediate trader and you don't subscribe to the 1 or 2 or 3 day viewpoint, and you find correlations like we're seeing in intercept, this could be a valuable tool for you. I tend not to trade on a weekly basis. And this is, as I said a moment ago, this is sort of new for me because I really didn't look at VRs on weekly or monthly, or even for that matter on a 60-minute or 10-minute chart. So there's a lot of opportunity here in testing the VR in various time frames. To answer the question, let me go back here. There's a question here. Do I provide any training classes or seminars? I'm planning on doing some personal mentoring, Michael. So that's coming up soon, where we do one-on-one. And if you email me, mark.vrtrader@gmail, I'll keep you posted on when that's going to happen. On the intercept, there was a question here. Why was a VR generated on January 8th? Okay, I assume this was on the daily chart.
Hey, Mark, while you're pulling that up, can I make a quick comment? Well, I would just, there's a lot of people on here who are asking about, they're asking about your training. And I wanted to mention to everybody, one thing that Mark has been doing for those who are subscribed to his VR indicator that you're looking at now in MetaStock, he has been doing some training videos almost on a daily basis. And he'll get in there and do some interpretation on what's hot and what he's trading right now. And we'll send that out to everybody who has that the indicator. If you don't have it, we want you to try it. The special offer that we're going to do here for those of you that are in the room, we're going to go ahead and give you 3 months access for the price of just 1 month. And I'll tell you, it should give you a really good run for what this can do to improve your trading. I always wish that most of our presenters would do what Mark does and kind of explain his methodology over and over and over. He does that for you even after you've got his system. So from a training standpoint, I just think it's a wonderful thing that he does, and the people who have the VR, they really like it, appreciate the training that he does for you. So just wanted to throw that out there. Thanks, Mark.
Sure. Somebody asked about the spiders or the S&P. I don't track the S&P futures, though you could pull it up here. I think I mentioned this earlier in the broadcast, where The Leibovit negative VR is clearly warned, and we were able to profit from the downtrend that we saw here into the beginning of February, but we did not get a positive signal off the bottom. So I am not long the market here. I've been playing individual stocks like the GWW and on and on and on. If you go to VR Trader, you'll see a bunch of stocks that we have been trading that did generate some signals and we did trade, but I did not play the indexes because even though we were oversold and coming out of it, and you might have just, you know, pulled yourself up from the your bootstraps and just jumped in because you just thought the market was going up and it looked like it was going to bounce, frankly, after the big sell-off, but without a VR signal, I don't do it. You know, I wait for the signal. So like back here, there's a little signal. Here's one. We got one, but immediately reversed. You know, here's one. It gave us a signal. This gave us a signal. So, well, you know, I'm just contemplating and talking off the top of my head here. I mean, is this a dead cat bounce? Is this a retest of the highs? Is this really a move to new highs? You know, without the volume there, it's difficult for me to make that call. And if we pull back and we generate a positive VR in subsequent days, then I might get long somewhere out here. But I did not get a reversal pattern right off the bottom. Though it did look like a bottom, and there were other indicators that said it was, the volume was not there. So I just don't take the trade, and I look for other opportunities, which, like I said, we did find in some individual stocks. I don't publish the formula for the VR indicator. We discuss it in the book. It is proprietary. It's not rocket science, but it's to our advantage, you know, to keep it a little bit under our hats so it doesn't appear on every platform on the planet. So I encourage you to sign up here and take advantage of the free trial and see if it helps you out. I mean, if it works for you, fine. If not, it's worked for me for 35 years, but, you know, everybody's got their own way of approaching the markets. And there's a question also how VR is drawn. I don't really understand the question. Basically, I'll do my best to interpret that for you. If you have a red bar here on the screen, that means it's a down day, it's a reaction day. And if it's in red, that means volume is increasing. So basically you're getting a down day, a more volume, so it's in red. And here you're getting in this bar here, just afterwards, we're looking again at the spiders, you're getting another down day, so it's color-coded in red. And the fact it's in red, it means that volume increased. So you can see here on the bottom with your bars, your volume bars, so volume increased on this bar versus this bar, and this bar versus this bar. So that was your negative VR. Volume increased coming off this high, generated the negative VR, and then we had an increase the next day following it on more volume. Now, of course, you know, I don't trade this. I mean, if I was short here, I certainly would probably have gotten out in a day, but you know, you're pretty oversold down here, and that's not the way I like to play the VRs. I more likely take a VR up here where you're overbought coming down on your stochastic than I would after you've already made a decline. So I might or may not have taken this trade, probably not, because we're already down quite a bit, but I like to catch, you know, VRs, positive VRs off bottoms and negative VRs more off tops. That's just the way I do, and I have the patience to wait for them. You know, we don't have to force a trade. Is there any possibility of using VR with currencies? Yes, absolutely, but I use the ETFs. Let me show you the Canadian dollar. We had this as a recommendation for a long trade. We just had a quick 1 or 2 day trade, and this is FXC, which is the ETF for the Canadian dollar, which, as you know, pulled back quite a bit as compared to the US dollar. But we made a long trade in this just for a quick trade here, and I'll show you what we did. And we follow the euro and the Japanese yen, and they all have some pretty good signals, but let's look at the Canadian dollar here. See, my philosophy is, you know, you're talking to somebody trade on the floor of the CBOE, and you know, I don't like, you know, you might think I'm a very risky trader, but I'm not. I think the odds are in my favor with what I do. I don't like futures. I like doing equities. I like to control my risk. I had a friend of mine who got wiped out on the floor of the border trade because he was in a bad position when the market went against him and went up in the limit, and he couldn't get out of his trades. If you're going to be in the futures market, I encourage you to use options versus the futures themselves, and that's just my philosophy. And that said, I have a lot of friends who day trade the mini S&P. I just, if you're in and out during the day, that's great. I just don't like carrying positions in the futures. anyway, we were long the Canadian dollar here. I had a positive VR. I got another one, and we were a little overbought, but I took the trade anyway because it was a second VR. It looked way oversold to me here relative to where it's been, and we got out. We actually took the trade real fast. We got out, I think it was either this morning or yesterday. I have to look at the screen, but we took a real trade. It took maybe like a three-quarters of a point or a point in the Canadian dollar here, but this is the kind of thing you're looking for, and here you can see the negative VR carrying it down for a few days. So there, you know, there is some... There is some correlation here in the currencies. I'm not saying it's 100%, but we do get some signals. But you can see what I was looking for. It was way oversold. It was down for a while, and I start getting signs of buying in the dollar, Canadian dollar, and it said to me, "Hey, we're going to get a bounce here." And sure enough, we got a little bit of a bounce. I'm not projecting any big turn in the Canadian dollar. Maybe this is the big bottom. I don't know that yet. I guess if it starts crossing above the 50-day moving average, but it was showing a little trade here, so we got in and out quick of that one. Could you check CALL out? That's another recommendation we're having here. So let's pull up that. We still have a little time here. And again, thank all of you for listening and coming on board here. I appreciate the following and the opportunity to show you the indicator. So we're looking at Magic Jack. I didn't even know what this was. Thank you. Never traded this stock. Well, this seems to be a pretty decent one here. Let's see what we got going here. Well, you know, you had already a big move here the last couple of days. And if you bought the VR from yesterday, you would have had a nice move today. I guess there was some news announcement in the stock, but just wearing my contrarian's hat, you can see this has been under accumulation for a while. You had a positive VR, you know, back here in mid-early December. It traded up and continued to trend higher. Then you had a number two. This was number one, you know, two in a sequence. So there was more accumulation. Number three, another more accumulation. And in this entire pattern, it never came back to under where the VRs were formed. This point, these points. So you had an ascending pattern, counting VRs. So a clear, you know, uptrending stock during this whole period. So, you know, I'd run like hell and take profits after this kind of move. That's just me. You know, if I was lucky enough to have been long, I might have been out of it here for a day or two trade. But if I jumped in here and I got a gap move like today, I would have been long gone in it. So, and the ingredients were certainly in place because the stochastic was turning up and, you know, the wind was at your back here for a trade. But there seems to be some nice correlation in the stock here. So this is one, I guess, for the future we got to keep an eye on. Then Brad says there was an influential hedge fund trader calling this the next Netflix. Okay. Maybe it is. Don't know. I'd love to find the next Netflix. We all would. We have about 5 minutes left. Any more questions? I'm happy to address them. I just feel like concentrating on a few situations like this makes more sense than throwing hundreds of examples up on the screen, and that's why I didn't spend too much time on that. I'd rather you... you sort of pick them. Dave, if you've got some other suggestions, here we are. There was a... I don't see any more questions coming in.
Okay. Well, first of all, I just want to say... Oh, it looks like we do have one more.
QIHU. You learn something new every day, Dave. Always a new one. I don't know which one to select here. QIHU. What is QIHU? What do I hit on the screen here? Is that the K? You know what that is? An ADR.
That's the dot K.
Hit the K? Okay. I'm putting it up. I don't even know what I'm looking at. So maybe our viewer can tell us what this is. QIHO 360 Tech ADR. There's some questions here about what we get when you get the subscription. I don't know what the vehicle is, but like anything else, you take the signals and you trade them accordingly. So, you know, starting around here, you're a little overbought here. I don't know if I would take in this VR. This VR I probably would take because you're coming out of an oversold reading. Negative VR here. You only had a day or two trade. Positive VR, you had a several day trade, but I've probably been out in a couple days. This VR didn't work. You had a 1 day sell off, but it wasn't coming right off the top. But you'd have been, I think you'd have been out of this because there was no follow through. So again, I don't know what QIHO is. Seems to be some correlation in it. If we can stick it on a weekly chart, you can see if there's any more correlation. And there's a positive VR way back here in April, but not much here on the weekly. Let's see other questions. If we get the system, what do we get? Dave, you might want to answer that question. And do you scan for ideas or just keep a small watch list? I generally keep a watch list. And, you know, I have a lot of clients and subscribers, and they'll call me during the day, hey Mark, check out XYZ, and I'll pull it up on the screen, and sure enough, there could be a VR or not. So I'm in a fortunate position of having, you know, a lot of clients who follow the market and are curious to see if a VR is coming in. So sometimes I get trades for things that I haven't caught myself because others are just emailing me to check out situations. But I do, to answer your question, I keep sort of a core watch list of a bunch of ETFs and about, you know, 30 or 40 stocks that I've traded over time pretty successfully. I do have a little bit of a bias to the gold stocks, which I've had some good luck with over the years. And I tend not to trade the very high price stocks, though I did trade the GWW in the last couple of days, like the Googles and so forth, the price lines. I tend not to trade $1,000 stocks. I tend to trade ones that are, you know, more reasonably priced. The add-on is, Dave, the add-on is what, $99 a month?
It's $99 a month, and we're going to give you 3 months to run with it. So you'll actually get it for, you know, between now and the next 3 months for just $99. If you have MetaStock already, that's all you pay, is just the $99. If you're new to MetaStock, you don't have the base program, you'll need that as well. But I tell you what we'll do is we'll give you the MetaStock and the data feed for 3 months as well for the price of just 1 month. So for those of you who have MetaStock, it's no absolute no-brainer. You need to jump in here and give this thing a roll, give it a try for 3 months. It's cancelable, of course, at any time. There's no risk to you. But outstanding presentation, Mark. I think what you've done is shown us what all of us are really trying to accomplish, is to make a living trading. And the interpretation that you're doing on this, I think, makes it very, very easy to see that anyone can do this. You can look through it. And Mark's going to give you a lot of training going forward via some short video clips to continue kind of walk you through it and make sure you understand how to apply it. But just a really great presentation of showing us how simple it is to really understand it and put it into good use. So for those of you who would like to take advantage of that, please do. It's kind of a no-brainer. Mark really knows his stuff, and his system obviously has been successful for him for 30 years. Put it to the test. All you have to do is just send me a quick email at dave.osmond@metastock.com. I'll type it one more time in there, and I'll personally set that up for you. Okay. The other thing you can do is you can contact us directly at our sales at metastock.com, and you will need to let them know that you were in the webinar. You'll have to say that to get the special offer on this. Okay.
Well, thank you all for tuning in today, and I hope all of you look forward to some of the videos. If you get on the list, it doesn't go out to the entire MetaStock list from what Dave tells me. So if you just sign up here, you at least get on the distribution list, and you'll see the periodic videos that I send out highlighting some individual situations that I'm involved with or looking to get involved with. So please do that. And again, I really appreciate you guys tuning in. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mark. Always a pleasure to have you in our room. We'll try to get you back in here again soon. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for coming over to the webinar room today. Best of luck in all your trades. We'll see you next time.